Private Kowalski, sir, reporting for orders.
At ease. Kowalski, reconnaissance has just reported that there is a column of German armored vehicles approaching. You will take part in the ambush. Go take your positions in the woods.
Yes, sir.
Dismiss!
They'll be here any minute. Destroy the first vehicle to block the rest. Don't fire without my order.
All these branches get in your eyes. I can't see a damn thing.
You should have come and camouflaged better then.
Quiet!
Surrounding us! Peter, watch our six!
Fuck.
Already here too.
Yourself. Grab AMSC and let's get to work. No time for jokes. Things are just as tough on the railway. The crowds are moving full steam ahead out of Yurata.
They must have been landed somewhere else too. They're about to go full steam ahead to hell. We'll show them just like we did outside of Moscow.
Yeah, hurt them so bad they lost their tanks.
I need two men, now! We can't hold both fronts! Kowalski, Augustinovich! Attack them from behind! Run to number two! It should be still clear from that side!
Yes, sir!
Hey, what it's like at the power station?
Catastrophe! They also came in from the beach. We'll try to catch them in a pincer movement.
I'll go with you. We won't do much here anyway if they surround us.
Everywhere.
Spangler.
Damn it, I won't get through.
On your right!
Kowalski, run to the machine gun next to the tower!
Yes, sir!
No, I'm getting it! No! Almost died again.
Boys are coming in front from the beach. Cover them! Quickly! What happened to our battery?
Everything is lost. We managed to get through at the last minute. Captain Pshibil and a couple of guys got cut off at number one. We weren't able to help her then.
We have to hold here. There's no other option.
All right, here we go! Peter, Irek, get over there and see how the guardhouse is holding up.
Thank you.
Ready, defend the tower!
We need to give the guys time to set the mines inside the tower. Krauts have surrounded us. They will have complete control of the bay if they get their hands on the battery.
No, Kowalski. No.
And that is how I came to be in this place. There is no more hope. At least I don't see it anymore. Hell, the last stronghold of freedom. I don't know if this is the end, but if you're reading this, it probably is.
It's over. So here is my thoughts, boys. So overall, it's 5 out of 10 game. So many stuff I didn't like about this game. There is game-breaking features. There was even a bug where I fell through the world. It was really annoying. But the most annoying thing was definitely the English voice actors. Here is an example of bad voice acting.
Stop! Die kommen, töte die!
And that's what fooling around gets. It was a trap.
You do not talk like this when somebody dies next to you. He's talking like the soldier who died is gonna respawn in a few seconds. Overall, through the whole story, they were talking like it's an airsoft World War II roleplay or something. There is no seriousness, no emotion, no screams, they're just straight reading out of the paper with their regular tone. However, after I finished campaign, I went to the sound settings and changed the dialogue language to the original Polish language. Even though I don't understand them, I felt the quality and difference.
Co chcesz przez to powiedzieć?
Zamknijcie się obaj. Musimy wyważyć drzwi, a potem szybko przebić się za osłonę. Za drzwiami już na nas czekają.
Ja się tym zajmę. Za mną, panowie.
Ignacy, stój!
Sie kommen, töte sie!
I tak kończy się pajacowanie. Zastawili pułapkę.
Szlak! Dobra, przebiję się na środek. Osłanie nie tylko.
Jasne.
I haven't been that scared in a long time, guys.
Harry, we were all just terrified. You are not alone, brother.
Enemy's dead ahead by the road. Peter, shut them.
Już dawno się tak bardzo nie bałem, chłopak.
Heniu, my wszyscy jesteśmy przerażeni. Nie jesteś sam.
Wrogowie na prostszej drodze! Piotrek, walnij!
As you can see, when they talk in their original language, you can hear the fear, excitement, and alertness. So if you're planning to play this game, I'm suggesting you to pick up the Polish language with the English subtitles for more realistic experience. When I played with English dub, I thought main character is a dick. He always talks disrespectful and kinda trollish to all of the ranks. But when I switched to the original language and the voice actor was actually a different one, were more mature than the English-speaking voice actor, which is probably another one from their crew. They just gathered Polish voice actors and said, who knows beginner English, who knows how to read, and just spreaded them for all characters in the game. This scene here, for example, Kowalski, our main character, talks to the high ranks. High ranks needs to be older because they're more experienced. They climb to those ranks with years. But in English dub, generals here talk like they're at their early 20s, where in the Polish dub, they actually sound mature, as it's supposed to be.
They really want this facility. We don't have much time.
As expected. What state are our positions in?
The eastern gate is secured, but will not withstand a lengthy attack.
So is it the western gate. This is where we expect the first shot to be fired.
I see.
Szykują się do zmasowanego ataku. Piechota i pojazdy pancerne. Bardzo im zależy na tej placówce. My mamy bardzo mało czasu.
Tego można się było spodziewać. W jakim stanie są nasze pozycje?
Wschodnia brama jest zabezpieczona, ale nie wytrzyma długiego naporu.
Tak samo zachodnia. Tam spodziewamy się pierwszych strzałów.
Rozumiem.
So if I was in place of the devs now, I would have removed English dub completely, but kept the English subtitle, of course. Because I've seen in the Steam reviews, most of the English-speaking players are actually not satisfied with the dub, same as me. That's the biggest con about this game so far. Dialogues really bored me up, especially after the Biomutant. This is like a torture. Another problem is AI. AI sometimes is extremely dumb, non-responsive, and sometimes fucking Terminator smart. I died multiple times, maybe over like 30 times for this whole campaign. Could be even more. Lots of time I started from the last checkpoint. Lots of failures, lots of rage quits. It's challenging. I mean, if you're looking for challenge, this game is what you're looking for. The thing with Call of Duty and Medal of Honor games, the game mechanics actually tells player what to do. But here, you're all alone. Everything is so random here. The world is completely against you. Even your own allies, they don't do shit. They don't shoot at enemies. Enemies just passing next to them. Not sure if this is a bug. They're just leaving all the enemies to you to handle. Music was good. There's no melee combat. There's just this stock animation. If you get in next to the infantry, that animation starts, which is boring. You're just tapping. To the keyboard, it's quite unnecessary. There is no melee combat. We have some weapon preferences, submachine gun, standard rifle, LMG, sniper, and we played with some vehicles as well. We played with the cute little tiny tank. By the way, that swamp mission sucked. I failed like over 10 times there. So yeah, if you being stuck on that mission, go watch previous episodes from this gameplay walkthrough. Some missions were good, some missions were bad. But overall, it's 50-50. This last one was kinda intense. First mission sucked. Extremely. A third mission was good, the one with the trench. The most hilarious one was the second mission. It is a standard mission where all AIs are becoming dumb. They cannot hit you, but you have the unlimited Hollywood machine gun and you're just killing hundreds of them. And it's hilarious and it's kind of disrespectful towards enemy as well. Just like developers said, this game was based on old school Call of Duty and Medal of Honor games. I raised with those games, so I'm not new to this style of gameplay. It feels extremely similar to 2005. But yeah, overall, This game is basically a 2005 or 2002 old style World War II game with better graphics, basically. Fire effect, explosions, they felt cheap as well. Most of the weapons felt unrealistic, sound and fire rate wise. So here is my final points for each category. It was interesting. Especially, I don't think I ever played any game that featured the Polish Force, so it was kind of a different aspect of the view. Not sure if all of these missions were historically accurate. I have zero information about the background, how this story and character name developed. And that's it, everyone. If you have your own opinion about this game, type in the comment section. I'll see you next time, guys. Peace out.